5-Minute Bios, short on time, long on info, with George Fritchie. Today, John D. Rockefeller. John Davison Rockefeller was born on July 8, 1839, in Richford, New York. He would become one of the most influential entrepreneurs and philanthropists in American history, instrumental in developing the oil industry and shaping modern business. Rockefeller grew up in modest circumstances and developed an early interest in business. As a teenager, he showed entrepreneurial skills by selling candy to friends and neighbors. And these skills laid the foundation for his later success. Together with a friend, he founded his own company called Clark and Rockefeller, which did business with agricultural products. This was his first step into the world of entrepreneurship. While in the mercantile business, Rockefeller became aware of the growing importance of the petroleum business. In the late 1850s, he invested in petroleum production and refining, and in 1863 he founded the firm Rockefeller, Andrews, and Flagler, which focused on refining crude oil. This refinery was the cornerstone of Rockefeller's empire. Rockefeller married Laura Celestia Spellman, also known as SETI, in 1864. She came from a wealthy family. The Rockefellers had a total of 4 children, Elizabeth, Alta, Edith, and John D. Rockefeller Jr., who would later play a prominent role in continuing the family legacy. In 1870, Rockefeller founded the Standard Oil Company, which was engaged in petroleum refining. Rockefeller recognized the potential of the emerging oil industry and focused on efficiency and cost-cutting to give his companies a competitive edge. Under his leadership, Standard Oil grew rapidly and soon dominated the oil market in the United States. Rockefeller focused on vertical integration, controlling his oil company from production to marketing. He acquired numerous competitors and established a complex network of companies that covered all aspects of the oil industry. This consolidation led to the creation of a near-monopolistic corporate empire. Rockefeller's business practices and exercise of monopoly power led to increasing criticism and legal challenges. Eventually, the U.S. Department of Justice ordered Standard Oil broken up in 1911, leading to the formation of several independent companies, including Exxon, Mobil, and Chevron. John D. Rockefeller was one of the richest people in history. It is estimated that his fortune was several $100 billion in today's purchasing power. And yet, he was known for extreme thrift and economy, despite his immense wealth. It is said that he gave his grandchildren $1 bills on their birthdays to teach them the value of money. Rockefeller was also a pioneer of modern philanthropy. After he dissolved the Standard Oil Company, he established the Rockefeller Foundation in 1913, one of the first major foundations of its kind. The foundation supported many areas, including education, medical research, public health, and social services. Much of Rockefeller's foundation's money went to educational institutions and research institutes. He supported the founding of universities, including the University of Chicago and Rockefeller University in New York City. John D. Rockefeller died on May 23, 1937, at the age of 97. He died at The Casements, his winter estate in Ormond Beach, Florida. He had purchased this estate in 1918 and used it as a place of recreation. After his death, John D. Rockefeller was buried at his family estate, Kaikit, in Pocantico Hills, New York. Kaikit is a historic landmark and in addition to the family tomb, is home to impressive gardens, artwork, and a significant collection of artifacts. Well, so much for John D. Rockefeller, and until the next episode of 5-Minute Bios.